Patriot, the edge in air defense. The aircraft destroyed here was only a drone, launched by our forces to test the effectiveness of the Patriot air defense system. But what if they were launched by the enemy, with skilled pilots intent on wiping out some of our most valuable assets? Let's go back a little and find out how you got here, and how important your responsibilities really are in the theater air defense network. Patriot fights as a battalion, but there are six firing batteries, and your individual battery is the basic operating element. Sometimes you'll hear it called a fire unit. The battery is 100% mobile. That means you won't have to worry about becoming a fixed target. The launching station carries four guided missiles, each in a reinforced aluminum canister. It's a self-contained unit that includes its own power plant and fuel. Your fire unit will normally have eight launching stations and is capable of operating up to 16. Another semi-trailer carries the radar set, capable of performing surveillance, target tracking, missile tracking, identification, and missile guidance. It is unmanned during operations and is controlled from the Engagement Control Station, or ECS. The ECS is the fire direction center of the battery and the only piece of equipment manned during the air battle. The electric power plant consists of two 150 kilowatt turbine generators mounted on a truck chassis, one for online use and one for backup. It provides electrical power for operation of the ECS and radar set. This is the antenna mast group. It consists of two masts with two antennas atop each mast mounted on a truck chassis. These antennas extend the range of the UHF radios and overcome line-of-sight obstructions. When the battery arrives on site, as a missile crew member 16 Tango or an operator maintainer 24 Tango, you're responsible for setting up the equipment and making it operational. Patriot is a fantastic weapon system, but it's only as good as the unit personnel who occupy the position and emplace the equipment as quickly as possible. And you may have to move the entire battery several times each day. Each launching station is emplaced by lowering the rear and front outriggers. After outriggers are deployed, the towing truck can be pulled away from the launcher station. Then, by operating the four toggle switches that control the outriggers, you can level the semi-trailer on a slope of up to 10 degrees. The missile canisters are raised to a fixed launch position, and the data link antenna rises at the same time. The launching stations are not physically connected to any other equipment. The data link antenna receives commands from the ECS and communicates launching station and missile status reports to the ECS. When a missile has been fired or another canister needs to be loaded, a crane is used to make the switch. Once the new canister is bolted down and grounded, a single cable hookup gives the missile electrical power as well as signal data. The radar set is connected by three power cables from the electric power plant and by a single data cable from the ECS. But the rest of its setup is a lot like the launching station. You'll use the built-in outriggers to get it level, then raise the radar antenna to its operational position. We'll come back in a moment and take a closer look at it. When the antenna mast group is in position, leveled, and the brush guards dropped, raise the two masts. Each mast has two antennas and can telescope as high as 90 feet. The antenna mast group will extend your communications with other fire units or with battalion. When the electric power plant is fired up, you can prepare the engagement control station for operation. But first, another brief look at the radar antenna. This may not be like any other you've ever seen. It's called a phased array radar, which means the face of the main antenna contains thousands of individual elements that focus radar energy. It picks up many targets at once without moving. And the operators in the ECS can select which targets they want to see on the display. All this is handled by computers. In a way, it's like the ultimate video game, because the computers provide an amazing amount of information. As an operator, the whole thing is at your fingertips. From your position at a console, you can select from a variety of options and control the action. With this kind of firepower, the potential action is tremendous. 8 launching stations mean your battery can fire 32 missiles. No single fire unit has full circle coverage, so the Patriot system is designed as an integrated battalion. Here in the Information and Coordination Central, or simply the ICC, the batteries are dispersed within an area called a sector. The total firepower is 192 warheads. Activity of the integrated battalion is controlled from this module that looks like the ECS. The ICC has its own communication and power units and communicates with your ECS through the same type of equipment you use. When the threat is real, you're the one at the controls, watching a display that can show you as much as you want to see. Map points, assets you're assigned to defend, your own sector boundaries, and places where hostile as well as friendly flights might originate. Suddenly you see them. Unknowns leaving the enemy area and coming toward you. But you can't be sure yet. The skies are crowded, so you ask your computer for help. Are these unknowns a threat? Are they flying within the speed and altitude our own aircraft know to use? Are they trying to jam our radar with electronic countermeasures? Can they prove who they are through identification, friend or foe, IFF codes that are transmitted by friendly aircraft? The computer sifts through the information and gives you the answer. The unknowns become hostiles. They're within range of your missiles. It's time for your decision to engage the targets. Pressing that switch will tell the computer to do a number of things in a fraction of a second, including picking the best launcher, making sure everything's working perfectly, and loading pre-flight data into the missile. There will even be another IFF check to ensure that each target is hostile. If the targets respond as friendly, the missile won't fire. But in this case, all missiles fire. And you watch as the missiles speed away at several times the speed of sound. Courses automatically corrected by the computer. Each is guided toward its intercept point. And a kill. For those of you fortunate enough to set it up and operate it, Patriot is an incredibly powerful and beautifully simple system. Patriot, the edge in air defense.